The House of Representatives becomes the latest victim of a cyber attack involving a government entity. The official website of the House of Representatives defaced with a certain Three Musketeers claiming the hacking. Some government agencies are now calling for additional funding as the Philippines deals with growing cybersecurity threats. Michael Delizo reports.
Hackers from a Uyghur country could be behind the recent cyber attacks on Philippine government offices, according to a group of cybersecurity experts. Among the agencies that recently suffered cyber attacks were the Philippine Health Insurance Corporation, or PhilHealth, Philippine Statistics Authority, and Department of Science and Technology.
There is a possibility that we're actually really, as a country, being targeted now, considering that we're trying to stand on our own two feet and stand up against a bigger country.
The Department of Information and Communications Technology admits they have been fending off thousands of cybersecurity threats. Out of 3,000 threats this year, 10% were successful, according to the ICT. The top targets are government agencies, academes, and telecommunication companies.
Marami lang po talaga sila because of the evolving geopolitical issues, and the Philippines as allies, which naturally makes us natural targets.
The Cybercrime Investigation and Coordination Center points out cyber attacks are happening not only in government agencies in the Philippines, but also in other countries. The CICC underscored the need to have enough funds to strengthen the country's cybersecurity posture. Compared to cyber criminals, the agency admits their resources are limited.
Hindi naman kami natutulog, no? Ginagawa natin yung dapat natin gawin. Kaya lang talagang ang budget ng mga cyber criminals ay sobra-sobra naman, siguro 100 times more than budget natin.
So, Undersecretary D said their initial investigation into the cyber attacks on the Philippine Statistics Authority and the Department of Science and Technology suggests the hackers are local threat actors. D adds the perpetrators are skilled and seems to be working independently. He also says the agency is constantly improving its capabilities through personal trainings and cooperation with like-minded countries. According to D, President Marcos has also directed them to have a more proactive approach on cybersecurity.
We're starting a competition among college students. It went for the entire year. Our finals is going to be this Monday. USA, UK, Australia. We're offering free training. We are partnered with Google, who is providing us with with 5,500 licenses for an online training on cybersecurity.
In the meantime, the National Privacy Commission has launched a database search portal designed to help PhilHealth members determine if their personal information were affected by the ransomware attack. In a statement, PhilHealth encouraged its members to only access the official PhilHealth member portal to safely check membership and contributions record and to avoid entertaining or clicking random or suspicious links. Michael Delizo, ABS-CBN News.